Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 4, that is underground cables. Here we are going to discuss about that insulating materials for cables. So let us discuss about that insulating materials for cables. As we know that very clear, instead of that overhead transmission system, here we are going to discuss about that underground cables as to carry that power in underground cables. The satisfactory operation of cable depends to a great extent upon the characteristics of the insulation use, because underground cables are used for LT cables, HT cables, then extra high tension cables, super extra high tension cables. So the type of insulation or the thickness of insulation is entirely depends upon that type of the service, or depends upon that amount of the voltage for which we are going to use. Therefore, the proper choice of insulating materials for cables is of considerably importance. In general, the insulating materials used in the underground cables should have that the following properties. It has that high insulation resistance to avoid leakage current and to avoid electron pockets via treeing, tracking and voids. High dielectric strength to avoid electrical breakdown of the cable. High mechanical strength to withstand that the mechanical handling of the cables, especially about that mechanical injuries and mechanical stress. Non-hygroscopic, that is, it should not absorb moisture from air or soil, or the moisture tends to decrease the insulation resistance and hastens that breakdown of the cable. In case the insulating material is hygroscopic, it must be enclosed in a waterproof covering like lead sheet. So it should not be non-inflammable, low cost as to make the underground system a viable proposition, and unaffected by acids and alkalis to avoid any chemical action for the underground cables. So it should possess high physical stability, chemical stability, non-inflammable, and should be low cost. Then only we can prefer this type of underground cables and its insulating materials. These are the various properties of that insulating materials. No one insulating material possesses all the above mentioned properties, because there are the type of insulating material to be used depends upon the purpose, I mean type of the service for which the cable is required, that means based upon the amount of the voltage, and the quality of insulation, that means in order to bring that, or in order to make that insulating material, and it the thickness of the insulating material and the cost of the underground cable should be in economical. So the quality of insulation to be aimed at, the principal insulating materials which are used in cables like rubber, vulcanized India rubber, impregnated paper, varnish cambric and polyvinyl chloride. So let us discuss about that. The first insulating material like rubber. Rubber may be obtained from silky sap of tropical trees, or it may be produced from oil products. It has relative permittivity, that is epsilon r, which can varies between 2 and 3. The dielectric strength is about 30 kilovolts per millimeter, and the resistivity of insulation, that is rho. Rho is the value around 1017 ohms per centimeter. Although pure rubber has reasonably high insulating properties, it suffers from some major drawbacks. For example, like it readily absorbs the moisture from atmosphere and from soil. Maximum safe temperature is low, because it can stand for a maximum of temperature about 38 degrees centigrade, because it is very soft and liable, and it can damage due to rough handling and ages when exposed to light. Therefore, pure rubber cannot be used as an direct insulating material. So the next class of one more insulating material, which is called as vulcanized India rubber. It is also represented short form as VIR. It is prepared by mixing pure rubber with a mineral material such as zinc oxide and red lead, etc., with a 3 to 5% of sulfur also we are adding, as to make that vulcanized India rubber. The compound so formed is rolled into thin sheets and cut into strips. The rubber compound is then applied to the conductor as an insulating material. But it is heated to a temperature of about 150 degrees centigrade while in the process of manufacturing. That's why the name itself here, it is called as an vulcanization, and the product is obtained known as vulcanized India rubber. So vulcanized India rubber has greater mechanical strength, higher durability, that means higher reliability because higher lifetime, and it can bear resistant property than pure rubber. That means the resistant property is greater than that pure rubber for vulcanized India rubber. Its main drawback is that the sulfur reacts very quickly with copper, and for this reason cables using vulcanized India rubber insulation have tinned copper conductors. The vulcanized India rubber insulation is generally used for the moderate voltage cables but not for high voltage cables. Next, one more insulating material called impregnated paper. An impregnated paper, simply called as paper insulating material. It consists of a chemically pulped paper made from wood chippings and impregnated with some compound such as paraffinic or naphthenic materials. The generally materials which are chosen to manufacture that impregnated paper, like pulped paper, wood chippings and paraffinic or naphthenic materials. This type of insulation has almost superior compared to the rubber insulation. It is because it has the major advantages, like its cost is low and its capacitance is low, high dielectric strength and high insulation resistance. The only disadvantage is that paper is hygroscopic, and even if it is impregnated with suitable compound materials, it absorbs moisture and thus lowers the insulation resistance of the cable. For this reason, paper insulated cables are always provided with some protective covering and are never left unsealed. So if it is required to be left unused on the site during laying, its ends are temporarily covered with wax or tar. So wherever we are using that impregnated paper or paper insulating material which is covered initially to the core conductors, then again it is covered by another layers of insulating materials like metallic sheet or lead sheet. Again it is followed by bedding, armoring and serving. So paper insulating material, it is not close any with the covering, any protective covering, but definitely it has that some other layers of insulating materials like bedding, armoring and again covering. There is no directly which is covered that paper insulating material for any cable. So it ends with temporarily covered with wax or tar. Since the paper insulating cables have the tendency to absorb moisture, that means it is high hygroscopic, they are used where the cable root has a few joints. So for instance, they can profitably use for distribution at low voltages in congested areas where the joints are generally provided only at the terminal apparatus. However, for smaller installations, that means for smaller installations where the lengths are small and joints are required at number of places, during that cases vulcanized India rubber cables will be cheaper and durable than paper insulated cables. Next one, varnish cambric. Varnish cambric, simply it is nothing but a cotton cloth impregnated and coated with varnish. This type of insulation is also known as empire tape. The cambric is lapped on to the conductor in the form of a tape, and its surfaces are coated with petroleum jelly compound to allow for the sliding of one turn over another as the cable is bent. As we know that very clear earlier what we discussed, like impregnated paper, however it is hygroscopic, as the varnish cambric is also hygroscopic. So if once it is hygroscopic, means this type of cables are always provided with some metallic sheet, then only we can look at its dielectric strength in an appreciable manner. The general dielectric strength for varnish cambric is about 4 kilovolts per millimeter and its permittivity, that means relative permittivity, epsilon r is equal to 2.5 to 3.8. Next one is polyvinyl chloride. This insulating material is a synthetic compound material. It is obtained from the polymerization of acetylene in the form of white powder. This material has a cable insulation. It is compounded with certain materials known as plasticizers, which are liquids and made up of with some boiling point. The plasticizer forms a gel and renders the material plastic over the desired range of temperature. Polyvinyl chloride has high insulation resistance, good dielectric strength and mechanical toughness. It can stand for high mechanical injuries and high mechanical stress for a wide range of temperatures. It is inert to oxygen and almost inert to many alkalis and acids. Therefore, this type of insulating material is preferred over vulcanized India rubber in extreme environmental conditions such as in cement factory or in chemical factory. The mechanical properties, especially like elasticity and polyvinyl chloride, are not so good as those of rubber, because polyvinyl chloride insulated cables are generally used for low and medium domestic lights and for power installations. Thank you.